bring as much joy to the Mr. Men and Little Misses as their cars. Out on the open road with the wind blowing through whatever hair they may have, the good people of Dillydale know how to get somewhere quickly and comfortably.
Oh, what a terrible day for driving. Too much sun, all this traffic. Oh, and would it be so hard to make a car seat that was comfortable? Now what? Great. Suddenly, there's not a car in sight. How am I going to get a ride home?
Hello there, Mr. Grumpy.
Oh, great, Miss Sunshine. As if my day wasn't bad enough.
Is there something wrong with your car? Or is your engine getting a suntan?
Apparently, my engine has overheated.
I have no idea what that means. I'm not mechanical. But do you want to ride back into town?
Do I go with her, or stay and get pecked by hungry buzzards? I think I'll stay.
But how will you get back into town?
You've made your point.
Hop in! Lucky I came along!
I'll be the judge of that. Why aren't we moving?
Because you're not wearing your seatbelt. Isn't it a beautiful day?
Keep your eyes on the road.
Look at those farms.
They smell.
And all the animals.
They smell worse.
What about...
Don't care for them either.
How did you know what I was going to say?
Doesn't matter. Drive. Can you roll up the window and turn on the air conditioning?
I don't have air conditioning. I like feeling the wind in my face. Oh, how about some music? I think the radio makes the trip so much more fun.
You took the words out of my mouth.
Get down, the boogie's got me.
I don't like that song.
Oh, I'm the one they call the Big Mask.
I like that one even less. Stop the car!
What? What happened?
Nothing. I suddenly had the urge to get a little exercise. I'll walk home from here.
Okie dokie. Great traveling with you.
It's unnatural to be that happy.
Okay, Dillydale Glee Club. Ready to rehearse?
Be it sail, whale, quail, or nightingale, everything is happy in Dillydale. There's never any reason to be crabby, mad, or frumpy, unless you're a certain Mr. Grumpy.
Oh, crooked cucumbers!
Thank you for letting me be your assistant, Miss Scary. I love helping.
After the race, I just might let you help me wash the car.
I bet this big truck is a little much for you, Mr. Strong?
Oh, yeah, not really. Piece of cake, Mr. Rude.
Good tidings, fellow competitors.
Have a chance against my rocket racer. It's got the power of 800 horses.
While that may be true, this car has the power of a one-legged ostrich.
Mr. Small is right. Have you ever tried to catch a one-legged ostrich? Oh, they're fast.
Fast? I'll show you fast.
Mr. Rude!
Daredevil?
Mr. Men and Little Misses, start your engine! Ready?
Uh-oh. Sounds like my engine is knocking. That could be trouble. Maybe if I speed up.
Miss Daredevil by a bumper! Miss Daredevil!
can do it, Mr. Nervous. Just one more lap, one more little lap. Go! Miss Scary!
Ready to eat my dust, Mr. Nervous?
Oh, I would never eat dust full of dirt and bad things you should never put in your mouth.
I mean, are you ready to lose?
Actually, I'm ready to turn and go back.
Too late to turn back now, Mr. Nervous.
There's hardly enough room for one car, let alone two.
That's the point.
Too close, too close. No, 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 no.
I win!
Who built a road barely wide enough for a bicycle?
Gee, he almost seemed like he was having fun that time.
Yes, Mr. Persnickety?
Good morning, Mr. Stubborn. I understand you have a car for sale.
Yes.
Well, I'm looking to buy a car. Something clean and well-maintained, preferably the color blue, with gray interior.
I have just the car for you.
Oh, goody. I knew this would be my lucky day.
The car is in perfect condition.
Perfect? Well, then why are you selling it?
Why should I keep all the good cars for myself?
Very generous of you. Well, where is it? All I can see is a rusty old wreck.
That is not a rusty old wreck. That's the car for sale.
But it's... disgusting.
Try to contain your enthusiasm. Come, let's take it for a test drive.
That's not necessary, Mr. Stubborn.
You must test drive a car before buying one. Don't you know anything? Here, catch.
The steering wheel feels a little loose. Not to mention covered in grease and grime.
That is not grease and grime.
And half the gas pedal is missing.
It is not missing. It is just small.
No, I can clearly see where the pedal snapped in half.
You are wrong.
That gauge must be broken. It says we're going 100 miles an hour.
There's nothing wrong with that gauge.
It just doesn't seem like we're going that fast.
Of course we are. They don't build them like this anymore.
What about all that black smoke?
What smoke?
The smoke pouring from the exhaust.
That lets you know the engine is working fine.
Oh, this is the worst car I have ever seen.
If that's your attitude, I'm not selling it to you.
Good.
I would give it away before I'd let you buy it.
Well, that's fine, because I don't want it.
I promise you, you are the one person on Earth who will never, ever own this car.
Hold on here. I have every right to buy that horrible machine. And that's just what I'll do.
No.
Yes.
No, I will not sell you this car.
I insist you sell me this car. Let this be a lesson to you, Mr. Stubborn. The customer is always right.
Miss Whoops. Now, who did you say was coming to take me home?
Mr. Scatterbrain.
Oh, maybe I should have called a cab.
Don't be silly. Mr. Scatterbrain was happy to do it.
Sorry I'm late. I had to return a wrench to a monkey.
Take good care of yourself, Mr. Bump.
See ya, fella. Here you go, Mr. Bump.
Are you sure this isn't too much trouble?
Oh, no trouble at all.
Ow!
It's good to know those still work.
Red light, Mr. Scatterbrain, red light!
Oh, I love this game! One, two, three, red light! Pick up hitchhikers, but who can refuse the chicken?
Hurts.
Boy, I guess it never pays to make a chicken mad.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Well, you're home.
Oh, thank goodness. Thanks for the ride, Mr. Scatterbrain. I'll never forget it.
Sure, Mr. Bump. Anytime.
You never learn.
And so it is that in Dillydale, no matter if you like to creep along slowly or zoom super fast, everyone loves driving cars. Of course, some cars are more fun to drive than others.